On the night of May the 26th, 1959, at Milwaukee's County Stadium, the Pirates' little left-hander Harvey Haddix pitched one of the best games in big league history and lost. Haddix and Braves right-hander Lou Burdett hooked up in a classic pitcher's duel. Burdett was dominant, but Haddix had been perfect. Let's pick up a dramatic Bob Prince in the bottom of the ninth inning.
Anything that Jim and I have witnessed in this season absolutely at this moment pales into insignificance. And we've had some thumpers. Here's the windup and the 1-2 pitch to Burdett. Foul off to the right out of play. And Burdett has shortened up the grip on that bat and is trying to really hang in there. And don't forget, he also is quite a threat at the long ball. Two men down. Last half of the ninth inning. No score. I can't repeat it enough. The 1-2 pitch. Stuck him out swinging. Haddix pitches a perfect nine-inning, no-hit, no-run game. A standing ovation. Ladies and gentlemen, Harvey Haddix has just become the seventh pitcher in the history of all baseball to pitch a perfect, no-hit, no-run, nine-inning ball game.
The matching goose eggs continued deep into the Wisconsin spring evening. After Burdett retired the Pirates in the top of the 13th, Prince gave the totals.
The Buccos do their 13 innings, or at the end of 12 and a half. Pittsburgh, no runs, 12 hits, no errors. Milwaukee, no runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody on base on an error or a walk.
Harvey Haddix had now retired 36 Braves in a row, and then Felix Mantilla led off the Milwaukee 13th.
Mantilla, bouncing ball to Pope, comes up on the big hop from third, throws into the dirt, the ball is dropped. So the Braves have their first base runner in Mantilla. An error is charged, and we'll see to whom.
The error was charged to third baseman Don Hoke. With a man at first and nobody out, Eddie Matthews came up. Matthews blasted 512 home runs in his Hall of Fame career. But in this extraordinary game, the slugger was laying one down.
Here's the pitch. There's the bunch right out in front of the plate. Up comes Haddix. He'll have to go to first base. On to Mazeroski on the sacrifice. Mantilla gets the second. And up comes Henry Aaron.
Aaron was intentionally walked, putting men at first and second with one away in a scoreless game. Haddix had still not allowed a base hit as he faced the final batter of the night, Joe Adcock.
Here's the pitch. There's a fly ball deep right center. That ball may be on through and over everything. It is gone. Home run. Absolutely fantastic. Haddix loses 3-0 on a one-hitter in the 13th inning.
Officially, the final score was 1-0 as Adcock passed Aaron on the base path between second and third. Aaron excitedly had run off the field after he saw the ball clear the fence, and Adcock was credited with a double, the only hit in 13 innings against Harvey Haddix. Haddix would finish the 1959 season with a commonplace 12-12 record, but many historians consider his 12 perfect inning performance to be the greatest big league game ever pitched. Lou Burdett later jokingly liked to brag, "The greatest game ever pitched wasn't quite good enough to beat me."